So this is a fluid exerting force which is taken as 3.6 kN per meter cube. And vertical force having unit weight of 9.2 kN per meter cube. Hence the total horizontal force will be equal to 3.6 into h square by 2, which is 1.8 into h square, that is kilonewton per meter run. And vertical force will be 9.2 into h square by 2, which is equal to 4.6 h square kilonewton per meter run. The long form of USBR is the United States Bureau of Reclamation. This is one of the recommendations. Provisions are made to take the values of this deposit silt, the pressure, fluid exerting force, which is taken as equal to deposited silt, may be taken as equivalent to fluid exerting force, which is taken as unit weight equal to 3.6 kiloton per meter cube in the horizontal direction. And in vertical direction, vertical force having unit weight 9.2 kiloton per meter cube is taken. From the recommendations of USBR, these values are taken while calculating the silt pressure. In case of if the upstream face is inclined, in that case, these values are taken. So, how to calculate this silt pressure? USBR is the United States Bureau of the Reclamation. And that recommendations are given. This is the silt pressure. After this, in most of the gravity dam design, the silt pressure is neglected. ग्रेविटी डैम में सील प्रेशर निग्लेक्ट करता बिकॉज इट इज नेग्लिजिबल द प्रेशर इज इज लेस द बेसिस फॉर निग्लेक्टिंग दिस फोर्स इज दैट वाई टू निग्लेक्ट दैट फोर्स इनिशियली स्टील्ड लोड इज नॉट प्रेजेंट ज्यादा तुम्ही वेन वी कंस्ट्रक्ट द डैम स्ट्रक्चर त्यावेळेस सील प्रेशर स्टील्ड लोड कमी असेल स्टील्ड लोड कधी वाढेल बाय द टाइम इट बिकम्स सिग्निफिकंट As the time elapses after 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, or more than that, the accumulation of the silt may increase. Initially, it will be less, or initially it may be less. In that case, that pressure is neglected during construction. So it gets consolidated to some extent and therefore acts less like a fluid. It is acts like a pressure of that seal which is considered as equal to the pressure of the fluid. Therefore, the pressure due to this seal may be neglected. The seal deposited in the reservoir is somewhat impervious, and therefore that will help to minimize the uplift. Under the dam, my silt deposit झाल्यानंतर it becomes impervious. काय silt कशी असतात? Impervious. Water will not percolate. It is impervious. Water will not percolate. त्यामुळे sometimes it minimizes, reduces the uplift pressure. Uplift pressure जे आपण पाहिले, ते काय करेल? Reduce करेल. अपली प्रेशर रिड्यूस करण्यासाठी आपण काय प्रयोजन करतो इन दॅट वी कन्स्ट्रक्ट द कट ऑफ वॉल कट ऑफ वॉलच्या जागी काय इथं काय प्लेस झालेलं आहे सिल्ट सिल्ट काय करेल ते पाणी पास होऊ देणार नाही ही विल नॉट पर्क्युलेट थ्रू दॅट सॉइल ऑन अपस्ट्रीम फेस ऑर बाय कन्स्ट्रक्टिंग द ड्रेनेज चॅनल्स ऑर बाय प्रेशर ग्राउटिंग इन द फाउंडेशन So it will minimize the uplift pressure under the dam. Therefore, this pressure due to silt is neglected. This is the reason of neglecting this force. Some of the silt pressure
Any difficulty? Then fifth type is wave pressure. Wave pressure diagram is the line. This is the gravity dam. The wave pressure, PW means wave pressure. PW is the wave pressure. The wave pressure intensity is shown by symbol. Here, this is due to fluctuation in the water level in case of tides. It will strike on the upstream face. म्हणजे वेव्स लाटा जे आहेत पाण्याच्या लाटा त्या अपस्ट्रीम फेसला काय होतात ते धडकतात. दीज आर द वेव्स प्रोफाइल ऑफ दिस वेव्स इन केस ऑफ टाइड. हाईट दाखवले पहा. इनिशियल हाईट वॉटर मॅक्झिमम वॉटर लेवल इट इज शोन हियर. आणि हाईट ऑफ दिस वेव्स इट इज शोन 2/3 HW/3 हियर. आणि इथून हे लाटा असं पहिल्यांदा ज्यावेळेस लाटा येतात त्यावेळेस पहिल्यांदा वरपर्यंत जाते लाटा. इथून परत ते खाली येते. खालून परत ते वर जाते आणि या डॅमला ते डॅमला जाऊन ते स्ट्राईक होते. इट विल स्ट्राईक टू दिस डॅम फेस. सो ड्युरिंग दिस केस इट मे फ्लक्च्युएट. मॅक्झिमम वॉटर लेवलच्या पेक्षा ते जी पाच जी लेवल आहे ते पहिल्यांदा जास्त होईल, नंतर ते कमी होईल, परत ते वाढेल. तर तो फ्लो म्हणजे लेवल कमी जास्त होईल कंटिन्युअसली. इट विल फ्लक्च्युएट ड्युरिंग वेव्स. मॅक्झिमम वॉटर लेवल त्याच्या हाईट इथे दाखवलं पाहिजे 2/3 HW. हिअर इट इज दिस ॲट दी बेस. बिलो द वॉटर लेवल हाईट इज HW/3 अँड अबोव द दिस वॉटर लेवल इट इज 3/8 इंटू HW अप टू दिस प्रेशर वेव वॉटर प्रेशर रिझल्टंट आहे. हाईट किती आहे 3/8 इंटू HW. आणि अपस्ट्रीम फेसला जो प्रेशर आहे रो W स्मॉल रो W दॅट इज रिंग हाईट इट विल हॅट ॲट द हाईट HW/8 फ्रॉम दिस मॅक्झिमम वॉटर लेवल. अँड हाईट ऑन डाउनस्ट्रीम फेस of this wave at which it strikes, height is given from this face, from this end, 5/3 into HW. These are the various mutations of this pressure. This is a wave pressure diagram. How to calculate this wave pressure? Waves are generated on the surface of the reservoir by the blowing wind due to wind flow. There is wind pressure jaast asel there is the waves kay hotat fluctuate hotat. Waves are created in the reservoir on the surface of the reservoir due to blowing wind. In some case there is water asel kiwa there is wind pressure jaast asel there is he waves kay hotat. Waves will flow on the surface of the reservoir which causes a pressure towards the downstream side. Downstream side la the pressure act hote. The wave pressure will depend upon the wave height. Wave height jevda hai tevda the wave pressure act hote. It depends upon the wave height. Ja ata apan pahile height diagram madhe the wave height 2/3 HW is the wave height. Depending upon that height of the wave, the pressure will be wave pressure will be calculated. The wave height may be given by this equation. The wave height kasa kadaycha ye formula hai. HW is equal to 0.032 root of v into f plus 0.763 minus 0.271 into f raised to 3/4. Is the equation of wave height. For f is if it is less HW manje kay height of water from the top of the crest to bottom of trough in meters. It is a height from top of the trace to bottom of the trough in meters, HW, wave height, which is taken, which is considered as HW. Capital V is wind velocity, which is measured in kilometer per hour. Wind velocity पण consider केलेले आहे यामध्ये, kilometer per hour. Per hour ना किती kilometer wind velocity. नंतर F, pitch or straight length of water expanse in kilometer. That is considered in kilometer. If it is less than 32 kilometer, then it is this equation is used. Top equation, high equation consider again. If pitch length is more than 32 kilometer, then this formula is considered. HW is equal to 0.032 root of V into F. इतने जन अंतर जो formula है 0.763 minus 0.271 F ratio 3/4 हाँ consider के लिए नहीं इसमें when F is greater than 32 kilometer, when F is less than 32 kilometer, then we have to add this value. समझला तुम्ही मतलब difference this way the wave height is calculated from that wave height जी आता या equation वरना तुम्हाला मिळालं त्यावरनं वेव प्रेशर काढायचं आहे मॅक्झिमम प्रेशर इंटेन्सिटी ड्यू टू
द दॅट वेव ॲक्शन वेव दॅट इज जनरेटेड वॉटर एक्सपॅन्स ऑर फेच लेंथ फेच ऑर स्ट्रेट लेंथ ऑफ द वॉटर एक्सपान्स कितीपर्यंत वेव जनरेट झाले त्याचं लेंथ फेच लेंथ स्ट्रेट वॉटर एक्सपान्स मध्ये वॉटर इज एक्सपांडेड द पोर्शन इट इज वॉटर एक्सपान्स द मॅक्झिमम प्रेशर इंटेन्सिटी इज कॅल्क्युलेटेड बाय दिस इक्वेशन PW इज इक्वल टू 2.4 इंटू गॅमा डब्ल्यू इंटू HW व्हॅल्यू किती आहे मॅक्झिमम प्रेशर इंटेन्सिटी 2.4 इंटू गॅमा डब्ल्यू इंटू HW गॅमा डब्ल्यू म्हणजे काय युनिट वेट ऑफ वॉटर अँड HW इज द हाईट ऑफ वेव ऑर वेव हाईट अँड दिस प्रेशर विल ऍक्ट ॲट HW बाय 2 मीटर्स फ्रॉम अबव द स्टील वॉटर सरफेस त्या वॉटर सरफेसच्या वर HW बाय 2 या डिस्टन्सवर काय ॲक्ट होईल मॅक्झिमम प्रेशर वेव प्रेशर shown here. The pressure distribution may be assumed to be triangular as shown in figure. It is shown in this triangular. The variation of the pressure will be in triangular direction. And the total force due to wave action PW that will be equal to the PW itla jo force hai ya diagram me dakav PW capital PW ite top la तो कुठे ऍक्ट होईल 1/2 HW/2 फ्रॉम दिस वॉटर सरफेसच्या वर HW/2 ते मॅक्झिमम प्रेशर इंटेन्सिटी असणार आहे तर टोटल वेव फोर्स कसं काढायचं ड्यू टू वेव ऍक्शन PW दॅट इज कॅल्क्युलेटेड बाय 1/2 PW इथे दाखवले पाहिजे स्मॉल PW अँड टोटल फोर्स विच दॅट विल ऍक्ट ऑन अपस्ट्रीम फेस ऑफ द डॅम दॅट इज कॅल्क्युलेटेड बाय 1/2 ह्याला 2.4 गॅमा डब्ल्यू इंटू HW इंटू 5/3 इंटू HW 5/3 इंटू HW काय आहे द टोटल हाईट ऑफ दिस ट्रँगल इथे राईट साईडला दाखवले पाहिजे 5/3 इंटू HW तो कुठे ऍक्ट होतोय PW फ्रॉम द बेस ऍट द डिस्टन्स HW/2 जसं आपण वॉटर प्रेशर काढलंय ट्रँगल कन्सिडर करून तसंच ह्यामध्ये सुद्धा वेव प्रेशर कसं काढलंय 1/2 बेस इंटू हाईट बेस काय कन्सिडर केलेलं आहे दिस
2.4 गामा डब्ल्यू इंटू एच डब्ल्यू हा बेस है इंटू हाइट का है ट्रायंगल की हाइट 5/3 एच डब्ल्यू इतना दाखिल पहा डायग्राम मे 5/3 एच डब्ल्यू ट्रायंगल की हाइट जाए बाय दिस फॉर्मुला गेट द टोटल वॉटर फोर्स ड्यू टू एक्शन इन दिस वे द वेव प्रेशर इज कैलकुलेटेड समझला हाउ टू कैलकुलेट दिस एनी डिफिकल्टी समझला का वेव प्रेशर This is a diagram of wave pressure diagram. इस अपन अपनी प्रेशर डायग्राम पहले वॉटर प्रेशर डायग्राम पहले हाँ वेव प्रेशर डायग्राम दिस वेरियस द ऑरिजिनल प्रेशर इट इज वेव वेव प्रेशर इज शोन इट हाइट फ्रॉम द वॉटर लेवल इट इज शोन वेव हाइट इज शोन द नेक्स्ट वन इज हाइट प्रेशर सिक्स नंबर ऑफ फोर्थ इज ice pressure pressure due to ice so ice pressure which is formed in the winter season or due to temperature variation due to change in the season the ice may be formed on the water surface of the reservoir on upstream face in cold countries In cold countries where coldness is more, where in case of the region where which are the dam structure which is built in cold region. In that case, the water which is stored, the ice formation may take place. So in that case, sometimes that. Ice may get melt in the summer season. In summer season, is there temperature variation? During ice formation, it will be in solid state. After melting of that ice, it will be converted into liquid state. During liquid state, while converting this ice into fluid. Then it will exert a pressure. It will expand. Melt zalamar kavil, ice melt zalamar kavil. It will expand. It will exert a pressure on the upstream face of the dam. So due to which it will resist the dam have to resist this thrust exerted by the expanding ice. Ice kavil expand with the temperature vadel. The ice temperature it may be zero or less than that. When the temperature becomes higher, or it may be 30 degrees Celsius, 25 degrees Celsius to 30 degrees Celsius, up to 40 degrees Celsius. When temperature increases, ice will melt. Melt zalamar kavil, it will be converted into water. If water gets that ice will get expand. And it will flow. Due to flow of that ice, it will exert a pressure on upstream face. This force is also considered while designing a dam. This force acts linearly along the length of the dam, and along the length of the dam, this pressure will exert ice pressure. And at the reservoir level, at top level, at the middle of the dam. This pressure will exert. How to calculate this magnitude of this force, ice pressure? Magnitude of this force varies from 250 kN per meter square to 1500 kN per meter square, depending upon the temperature variation. How force kasa vary hota hai? Kadhi 25 degree Celsius kami asel the pressure magnitude of force. Jab is temperature jaas asel, jab is to 1500 pounds is of course actual. When the temperature is minimum, it may be 250 to 300, 250 to 500. If the temperature is higher, then it will become 1000 to 1500 newton per meter square. Depending upon the temperature variation, this magnitude of force will vary. On an average, the value of this force may be taken as value of 500 newton per meter square may be allowed under ordinary condition. Ordinary condition मध्ये ज्यावेळेस temperature middle असेल, medium असेल, त्यावेळेस ही value consider काय असेल? 500 kiloton per meter square. This is the ice pressure. Pressure due to this ice that is considered as 500 kiloton per meter square within this 250 to 1500 kiloton meter square. Within this value 250 to 1500 kiloton per meter square. In between that, for ordinary condition, ordinary temperature, the value of this force is considered as 500 kiloton per meter square. So, the ice pressure का सर कहने से the last one is weight of the dam. Due to its own weight, it will exert a force, the major resisting force. Weight of the dam body and its foundation, the major resisting forces will withstand the water pressure, ice pressure, silt pressure, then seismic forces, wave pressure is a major force, resisting force, that is weight of the dam. In two-dimensional analysis of the gravity dam, unit length of the dam is considered. Unit length up to 1 meter is considered while designing the one analysis of this gravity dam. That is analyzed by two-dimensional analysis. This is the method of analysis of the gravity dam. Then cross section can then be divided into rectangles and triangles. Cross section can be divided into rectangles. Cross section of the dam. While analyzing or calculating the weight of the dam, the initial so the shape kaisa hai? Upstream face vertical hai, downstream face inclined hai. Sometimes upstream face is partly vertical, partly inclined. In that case, all that dam structure is divided into parts. The triangle consider karun the area kadaycha hai, and the rectangle or the triangle on downstream face. In this way, it is analyzed. Rectangles and triangles are divided into this section. Then the weight of each along with their CGs can be determined. CG of the triangle, CG of the rectangle. मैं यहाँ diagram में दिले पा. हाँ, dam structure है. इथे मिडल ला काय लेफ्ट ला अपस्ट्रीम फेस ला तो ट्रायंगल पोर्शन आहे इथे हा एक ट्रायंगल येईल फ्रॉम ए डी टू दी बॉटम हा ट्रायंगल आणि मिडल ला हा टॉप वन लेवल विड्थ ऑफ द डॅम इथून हा रेक्टँगल खालीपर्यंत इथून हा परत डॉटशिम साईडला हा मोठा ट्रायंगल इथे लहान ट्रायंगल आहे आणि इथे मोठा ट्रायंगल आहे सीजी आता वेगळा असणार आहे वर असणार आहे या ट्रायंगलचा सीजी खाली असणार आहे आणि या रेक्टँगलचा सीजी मिडल असणार. So it is this cross section of the dam is divided into triangles and rectangles. Samajhna? By considering these sections, from that you get the you have to add this weight of this triangle, two triangles, and weight of the rectangle. Add karun kay mil? Total weight of the dam. Weight of the rectangle plus weight of the triangle. Which is located on upstream and downstream face. The weight of this each sections which are considered, weight of each sections are determined. The resultant of all these downward forces will represent the total weight of the dam acting at the CG of the dam. May addition of this triangle, don't triangle size. एक रेक्टेंगल है वेट ऑफ दिस टू ट्रायंगल्स प्लस वेट ऑफ रेक्टेंगल ऐड करून काय मिळेल टोटल डाउनवर्ड फोर्स टोटल वेट ऑफ द डॅम एक्टिंग ऍट द एज ऑफ द डॅम स्ट्रक्चर कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ फोर्सेस मे बी ऑल्सो बी कन्सिडर्ड वाय डिझाईनिंग द डॅम स्ट्रक्चर वेन द रिझर्वर इज फुल अँड वेन द रिझर्वर इज एम्प्टी रिझर्वर इज फुल म्हणजे काय ज्यावेळेस वॉटर लेवल मॅक्झिमम पाण्याची जी पातळी आहे मॅक्झिमम वॉटर लेवल असेल हायस्ट वॉटर लेवल किंवा हायस्ट फ्लड लेवल इथपर्यंत कन्सिडर करून तो डॅम काय करायचं डिझाईन करायचं सेक्शन अँड वेन रिझर्वर इज एम्प्टी ज्यावेळेस पाण्याची लेवल कमी असेल किंवा पाणी नसेल ऑप्शन साईडला आणि त्यावेळेस तो डॅम स्ट्रक्चर फोर्सेस काढायचे डॅम स्ट्रक्चर डिझाईन करायचं इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ फोर्सेस वेन द रिझर्वर इज फुल अँड वेन द रिझर्वर इज एम्प्टी बाय कन्सिडरिंग दिस टू केसेस द डॅम इज फोर्सेस ऑन द डॅम स्ट्रक्चर इज डिझाईन So in case of when the reservoir is full, then major forces are acting on the dam. त्यामुळे काय काय आता आपण पाहिलंय वेट ऑफ द डॅम एक्सटर्नल वॉटर प्रेशर आपण काढलंय अपटिक प्रेशर अर्थक्वेक फोर्सेस वेव प्रेशर वेन द रिझर्वर इज फुल दीज फोर्सेस आर कन्सिडर्ड मायनर फोर्सेस आर स्टील प्रेशर हाई प्रेशर अँड वेव प्रेशर आर द मायनर फोर्सेस आर द forces which are considered when reservoir is full. Normal load combination may be taken, water pressure up to normal full level, normal uplift, field pressure and ice pressure which are considered. This is a load combination may be taken. This class of loading is taken when ice force is serious, when ice force is considered. Then this load combination may be used. Then water pressure up to normal full level, normal uplift, earthquake forces and steel pressure, this combination may be used. Or water pressure up to maximum water level, maximum reservoir level, or normal uplift, steel pressure, this combination may be used. In extreme load combinations may be water pressure due to maximum full level, extreme uplift pressure without any reduction due to drainage and seal pressure. This load combination may be used. Any doubt in this? Any problem? When the reservoir is empty, empty reservoir, bending diagrams, the bending stage distribution diagram may be drawn for empty reservoir bending diagrams for reinforcement design, for grouting studies and other purposes. Then empty reservoir with horizontal earthquake force produced towards the upstream has to be checked for non-development of tension at toe. When the reservoir is empty, there is no water pressure, the horizontal earthquake forces are taken into consideration. And to draw the stress distribution diagram at the base of the dam. These are the various load combinations are taken while calculating the forces on the dam or analysis and design of the gravity dam. These forces have to be considered. Similar forces on the dam structure. So here we will stop. In next lecture, we'll see the modes of failure and criteria for structural stability of the gravity dams. Samajh aaya paryant? Any problem? Any problem in this? Samajh aaya process? Can ask any doubt in this? Okay, we'll stop here.